that.
Yeah, but I'm gonna probably neck out and see whether it's on my page.
You're late to give me an idea versus.
Community issues too, where you have transferable access given the proximity to houses. Also, the amount of residential housing that is fine.
Proposed use of the land for car parking would result in a detrimental change in the character of the area. Has the potential to cause nuisance to neighbouring residential uses in respect of increased noise and disturbance as a result of increased coolings and goings by considerable numbers of cars and vehicles. The proposals are therefore contrary to policy HS 15 of Wirral Unit Development Plan. That strikes me as the compromise that deals with a development in close proximity to residential housing. Though during the course of the debate it's clear members had fair concerns about sustainability, which was brought out by everybody else. So, like Phil, I think I would like to look, notwithstanding Matthew's opinion on this, whether we can add to that form of words which deals with inappropriate development in the residential area, to also say that the proposed use of the land for car park is contrary to the section 4 of the National Planning Policy Framework. I think I want to steer into those particular paragraphs in the National Policy Framework, but section 4 as a whole strikes me as a section that wishes to promote sustainable transport, and that's an issue that's been raised in the World Council.
Can we just stick to the words of the committee?
So, I'd also like to test, the idea that really when you have a grocery car park with so much capacity, that there must be, if you build a car park, cars will come, and that's the issue.
Thanks, Stuart. So, we've had that moved by Phil Brightmore with the assistance from Stuart Kelly in the form of words. I just really want to second in that, please.
Of course.
Stuart, thank you for that. Okay, can we go to the vote on the motion to... Sorry, the officers just need to get some clearance on this.
Okay, I think I've got the words for refusal, the first grounds. I think it's much clearer to have two separate reasons for refusal because in the event of any appeal we would need to deal with each issue separately. So I think I understand the first reason for refusal. I just need a little bit more clarification around the second reason for refusal. And I think what I'm hearing from members is around an issue of sustainable transport, proximity to other modes of transport already being there, and perhaps unnecessary traffic in a primarily residential area, something along those lines. And what I'm looking at is using policy TRT3, which is around transport and the environment. So if they're the sorts of issues that members are raising as a second reason for refusal, then I can form a reason on that basis. But I just need to understand exactly what it is that you want that second reason to be based on.
I'll be happy with the proposal. Okay, we're ready to go to the vote. All those who would like to go against the officer's recommendation, all those in favour of refusal? That's unanimous.
Thank you.
Okay, can I ask the members of the public to go as soon as you can, please, so we can carry on business. Thank you. Okay, we're going to revert now to the order of the agenda. So it's agenda item four, which is on page 15. Matthew, can we have a presentation, please?
Thank you, through you, Chair. This is an outline application with all matters reserved for subsequent approval. The application follows an earlier proposal which was refused for the reasons set out on page 70 of your report. This current application has sought to address and overcome those reasons for refusal. Although the application is a full outline, an indicative layout plan has been submitted which demonstrates how the site could be laid out with the number of units being applied for. That indicative layout has regard to plot layouts in the immediate vicinity of the site, existing mature vegetation and landscaping, and also to the frontage onto Springfield Avenue. The number of units now proposed is reduced from the number refused in October of last year, allowing for more space around each dwelling and a layout that follows the existing pattern of development in the area. The existing dwelling is in a poor state of repair and has been vacant for some time. The gardens are unkept and overgrown, and trees on site are subject to a preservation order. The submitted indicative layout also demonstrates that the site could be laid out in a way which achieves expected separation distances, maintaining acceptable levels of privacy between the new dwellings and existing properties. The reduction in the number of dwellings proposed for the site has also reduced any potential impact on the trees present on site, protecting the operational space around them. Trees will be retained along the Springfield Avenue frontage, maintaining the landscape character in this part of the neighbourhood. Whilst affordable housing provision is not proposed on site, the developers have agreed to a monetary contribution towards off-site provision via a commuted sum. Attempts have been made by both the applicant and the council's housing team to secure a registered social landlord for the site, but given the small numbers of units proposed, no interest has been forthcoming. The proposals are acceptable having regard to the criteria set out in Policy HS4 of the Unitary Development Plan and the requirements of the National Planning Policy Framework. As such, the application is recommended for approval, subject to a Section 106 of the legal agreement. There is one minor amendment to the report proposal. We're proposing a rewording of Condition 8 to read, prior to the commencement of development, details of a full scheme of works to construct a footway 2 metres in width along the frontage of the site shall be submitted for approval in writing to the local planning authority. The work shall be completed in accordance with the details prior to first occupation of the dwellings hereby approved. That's a slight rewording of the condition that's shown on the agenda item. Chair, there is a qualifying petition of objection.
Would the petitioner like to come forward?
No way that the ambulance or the lorries delivering slate or gravel or whatever can get down if we've got that part. Now people are parking on that particular pavement now. So when there's other cars, visitors to the properties and things like that, there's nowhere for them to park, and all the people who park there now will have nowhere to park. So please reconsider. Less properties, we're all wanting someone to buy it and change it, because it's very sad. And you've already said that there's care being taken of the trees and the wildlife. It's the actual number, and five bedrooms is going to be more than one or two cars, and the road can't take it, it's dangerous now. So basically that's all I can say. The dentist, he will lose his business, because people use that curve to park their cars when they go into the dentist during his opening hours. So there's going to be absolute bedlam. It's going to wreck the lives of the people on the estate as well, because they use it to come in, come down Frankie Road, into the estate, out of the estate. And it's just not going to happen if you get permission for those number of houses. So I'm shaking like a leaf, so that's all from me. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Would the applicant or agent like to come forward? No, is there a ward council that would like to speak?
It's Councillor Jeffrey Watt, SKB and Thurston Ward. Thank you for hearing Mrs. Smith speaking on behalf of the petitioners. I was coming here tonight to say to you, I think everything's right about this application except for the traffic, which is exactly what Mrs. Smith has said. I mean, looking at, as we referred to, previous applications clearly overdevelopment. I'm very pleased to see that the number of plots has been reduced in this case now. And in fact, rather sort of conveniently, it now matches the number of vacant numbers on that side of the road. Seven plots, and the next house is number 16. And they clearly, in terms of the plot width, match the houses on the other side of the road. I'm not exactly overjoyed by the indicative design of the houses. As you've heard, they're five bedrooms. They look like, beach huts or Swiss chalets or something like that. I don't think they're entirely appropriate for this road, so it's clear this is only an outline with indicatives, so you're going to have to look at it with reserved matters at a later date. I would hope that the applicants would come back with something better. I don't know why they necessarily have to be five bedrooms, whether that's really appropriate for this particular area, but clearly they do want the best use of the land. Reference was made to the condition number 8. I'm just wondering whether there's any indication you can see what's proposed actually for the highway footway issue. But Mrs. Smith has actually said in Teddy Hall, this is the main exit from that 1970s development. 100 houses or so were not close behind. I myself used to live about 50 yards from here, and this was my main exit onto the main road. It was difficult then, it's more difficult now. It's not a very wide or well sightline junction, and traffic is coming in quickly immediately from the 50 to the 30 mile limit, just a few yards before it, or accelerating away from the built up area, anticipating going out. I hope there's some way you can condition this. Earlier in your meeting, reference was made to your planning, your parking policy, which I know as a ward councillor coming to visit this meeting on occasion, sitting on the committee as a deputy, seems to, I think, all of us as a real no-brainer. We have a maximum policy rather than a minimum policy. And in this case, they're asking for five bedroom houses. Yes. They have garages and driveways. I would hope that when you come to either this stage or reserved matters, you could put something on it that would make sure that those parking spaces are retained and those garages stay at garages, don't become extra rooms. Somehow you've got to control the number of vehicles that are going to be added to going out of this road. And I hope that by that time you can have a parking policy which might help towards that. And one last thing is the plot, the first plot, which would be number two, SPRINGFIELD AVENUE, is marked down as a bungalow, and I hope that you can condition that either in terms of number of stories or ridge height to ensure that it does remain as a bungalow. There's no question of it turning into a 2.5-storey house at some time in the future. Well, you know, generally welcome what has been done, but please look at this parking and traffic problem and try and do something for the residents of this area. Thank you.
Thank you. We do have to look at this application and stand before us today. We can't consider the bills, surrounding buildings at this point. The petitioner and the board councillor both raised concerns regarding highways and parking. Would you just have some comment on that, please?
Thank you, through you, Chair. This is a formal application for all matters reserved. I think there is an indicative plan that's been submitted with it. Obviously, we need to look at parking provision when the reserve matter application came in. In terms of traffic generation, for six dwellings, it's minimal traffic generation for six dwellings. So I'm not concerned regarding that aspect of this application. So in highways terms, as it stands as an outcome.
Can I just say there is
six houses in the bungalow, sorry. The traffic generation from that is minimal. So in terms of highways, not overly concerned about this application, subject to the reserve matters if the outline is approved.
Okay, well done, Matthew.
It's just a quick question regarding the affordable housing provision. I know you said that no sort of registered social landlord was willing to come forward to make sure that that could happen. Does it have to be a social landlord to do that, or is there? Yeah, it does. Thanks.
David?
Yes, thank you, Chair. I endorse all the points that my ward councillor colleague has made and Mrs. Smith has made. This is an ideal use for a site which would otherwise be deteriorating rapidly, but I do share very much, using the road regularly, I do share very much the traffic. I'm wondering whether there's any way at this stage, not only outline, but whether there's any way at this stage we can ensure that adequate parking is contained within the site rather than risking it being parked out on SPRINGFIELD AVENUE. I don't know whether that's a possibility and if it's something that can only be done at reserve matter stage, but I think people would be a lot happier, I would certainly be a lot happier, and I'm sure the residents would be a lot happier if there was some mechanism by which we could ensure the parking there does not become a problem that makes the place unbearably horrible to live near to.
Through you, Chair, as I outlined in my presentation, this is a full outline application. All matters reserved for subsequent approval. The Council retains a significant level of control through the reserved matters application around details related to scale, appearance, sighting, parking, all of those sort of issues. So they would be best addressed at the reserve matter stage. We've tried to tie the application down as far as we're able with the outline, but as I said, a lot of that detail will come forward with the reserve matter application.
Thank you very much for that. But just for people who don't understand the planning process, you may be here tonight in the audience. I just wanted them to understand that we do have a high degree of control at the reserve matter stage. This is really just giving agreement in principles for the development to take place in accordance with what is being proposed. And as far as I'm concerned, I know I would want to ensure, if I'm involved in the decision, that this parking situation is adequately covered at the time of the reserve matter stage. And because I agree with everything that's been said from both my ward councillor colleague and from Mrs. Smith. So on those grounds, I'm happy to accept the development in principle with those caveats at a later stage. Thank you.
Is there anybody else that would like to speak? Do we have any David and a seconder? Thank you. All those in favour? And those against? The now going to go to agenda item 5, which is page 23. Matthew, can we have the presentation, please?
Thank you, through you, Chair. This application was subject to a member's site visit on Monday and seeks permission for the erection of an energy from waste facility and ancillary development. The application is a resubmission of a scheme that was approved in 2009 and which was implemented in 2012. That permission remains extant following the works to implement that permission. The principal changes relate to differences in the processes now proposed, which have necessitated a new layout for the site. Changes to the processes now proposed have resulted in the site being laid out with a number of smaller, separate buildings instead of the previously approved one larger building. The new scheme is laid out around two main buildings, together with two separate office and welfare buildings and other ancillary structures, such as fuel silos and effluent treatment plant. The other principal change is the height of the stack approved at 45 metres, which will now increase to 80. Although some of the processes are changing, the principle of this development has already been agreed and established through the earlier, now implemented permission. The process changes will actually result in improved and lower emissions, which is a change that should be welcomed. Although the site layout will change, fundamentally the use of the land for the purposes outlined in this report remain unaltered. All traffic and transport related issues remain as approved in 2009, and conditions outlined specifically around a travel plan and a construction management plan will ensure traffic related matters are properly controlled. The current proposal before members this evening offers an opportunity to improve elements of the processes involved, which will result in more efficient processes and improved emissions, although the proposals remain fundamentally unchanged in terms of function and role. The site is located in an area surrounded by other industrial uses, such as oil refineries and oil storage depots. All environmental issues, noise impacts, and air quality issues have been addressed in the submitted environmental statement that supports this application. The proposed changes to processes internally within the plant will not result in any increase in noise or potential for air pollution. In fact, the changes proposed will result in an improvement on those impacts identified in 2009. In summary then, the proposals represent a change to the layout of the site to those approved in 2009, necessitated by changes and improvements to internal processes. The principle of this development and the use of the land for these purposes has already been established and the consent has been implemented. As already outlined, development remains fundamentally as approved and the changes to processes internally and lower emissions as a result is considered to be acceptable. The site layout changes are not considered to result in a change that would warrant a refusal of planning permission. And in fact, the layout sits within its surroundings without any detrimental impact arising. Traffic and transportation issues remain unchanged as a result of the changes to the site layout, and suitably worded conditions as previously attached to the 2009 consent are carried forward with this new proposal. The application is recommended for approval. There is no qualifying petition of objection.
Is there a ward councillor who'd like to speak to this?
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Chair. I was delighted that a few members were able to visit the site visits on Monday last. I think it was beneficial for those members that came to see the actual layout and movement of vehicles. I'm here representing constituents from the Eastham Village, which is just off the picture. It's a medieval